Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how enamines provide a very effective way to alkylate ketones. At the top of the screen is a ketone alkylation. You take a ketone and treat it with a really strong base, normally LDA, to make an enolate. The enolate is then a strong nucleophile and reacts with a primary alkyl halide to make an alkylated ketone. This reaction is very important, but LDA wasn't widely used in organic chemistry until around the late 1960s. What did chemists do before then? In other playlists, we've seen alternative methods, including extensions of aldol condensations and the acetoacetic ester synthesis. As it turns out, enamines gave another alternative to early organic chemists. At the bottom of the screen is a ketone forming an enamine through reaction with a secondary amine. The alkene of enamines is fairly electron rich because the amine with its lone pair is an electron donating group. The alkene is actually so electron rich that it perhaps surprisingly can attack electrophiles like primary alkyl halides. The lone pair on nitrogen swings down, breaks the C-C pi bond, and attacks the alkyl halide. This forms an ENAMINE ion. The ENAMINE ion can be treated with water and hydrolyzed to give a ketone. So, enamines provide a method for converting a ketone on the bottom left to an alkylated ketone on the bottom right without requiring a base like LDA. This process was developed by a scientist named Gilbert Stork back in the 1950s, before chemists generally knew about LDA. This process is called the Stork enamine alkylation. Let's see an example of the Stork enamine alkylation in action. To the far left is a ketone, and we want to alkylate it. Let's say we want to put an ethyl on the alpha carbon. So let's take the ketone and react it with a secondary amine, something simple like dimethylamine. For this ketone, there are two possible enamines. The top structure, which puts the alkene on the less substituted side of the ketone. The bottom structure puts the alkene on the more substituted side. Enamines tend to form so that the alkene is as substituted as possible. So we'll get the bottom regioisomer, not the top. We can treat the enamine with ethyl bromide. This gives us an aluminum ion. There's our new ethyl group. And then we treat this in a later step with water, hydrolyze the aluminum ion, and there's our alkylated ketone. That's the power of enamine alkylation. Enamines are a simple method for preparing an alkylated ketone. The process begins with a ketone, requires formation of an enamine, alkylation, and then hydrolysis, and is called the Stork enamine alkylation.